Hi, I'm Laird Hamilton, and you're watching Behind the Brand with Bryan Elliott.
Hey, I'm Bryan Elliott. Welcome to another edition of Behind the Brand. Today I'm here with big wave surfer, athlete, entrepreneur Laird Hamilton. Can we talk about your training, your regimen?
Absolutely.
Talk about, you know, what are you eating for breakfast, lunch, dinner? How are you, you know, at this stage of your career, still, you know, looking amazing? Like you just, you know.
Yeah, the way I approach my fitness is pretty all-inclusive. So it's everything. It's eating, hydration. I mean, I'm always looking for, you know, ways to hack into my health. And it's the you know, the quality of my sleep, you know, I have a ton of hacks. I hate that word hack, because sometimes it makes me feel like you're getting something by not doing anything.
Yeah, there's no shortcutting. Just finding a more efficient way to do it.
More efficient ways, and my training is extremely diverse.
Okay, so let's make it linear.
Yeah.
Let's start in the morning. You're waking up at?
On average, I wake up at like 5:30.
Okay, and then? Walk us through the day.
Right, here we go. First thing, I wake up 5:30 in the morning. Very first thing that I do is I always shower. Always shower, brush teeth.
Floss. Hot shower, cold shower?
Hot, cold. Always finish on cold. Pretty hot initially. Oral hygiene, shower, make bed, oral hygiene, shower, large amounts of water, probably with Himalayan salt or something.
So you're making your bed. You mentioned making
my
bed.
My half.
Okay.
My half as part of a thing that I do. Okay. I'm pretty ritualistic in the way I do it. And I heard a general speak once, about it, and he said the reason why you make your bed in the military, why do you think they make the guys make their bed?
Maybe so there's no chance to jump back in it.
Task completion. It's all about task completion. So I start out by finishing things. So I go down and then I hydrate, because you've been sleeping for a long period of time. And so you need hydration. So I have some, and I use Himalayan salt, maybe lemon. I use some hydrogenated water or some kind of, you know, filtered water, a couple big glasses of water just to hydrate myself. Then I have I have some products that I make, superfood creamer products, but I make a concoction, which is like my version of a energy drink, of a smoothie, but it has to do with fat and caffeine. So I use a bunch of high quality coffee espresso fat. And then in the interim of that process, I usually put away all the dishes that are in dishwasher, clean all the sinks, wipe all the counters, just make the kitchen so that it's completely fresh for the day. Again, task completion. So I've completed another task now. And then it's some sort of reading during that time as well. So some sort of a digestion of some information, whatever that is. From Sapiens to Homo Deus to Natural Born Heroes to the Plant Paradox to the Blue Zone to the, I mean, it's something to do with, I like facts, and I want things that are connected to what I'm doing. Because when I talk about health, I talk about it like a wheel, and it's the spokes of a wheel. There's a lot of spokes on one tire, and your health is a tire. And so every spoke, you know, information, what are you listening to? What are you looking at? What are you eating? All these things are incorporated. So, once I kind of go through that morning ritual, then I go into training. Then I go into like extensive training.
I want to just dig in a little bit deeper on the reading thing, and maybe, you know, self-improvement. I don't know if you're like me, but I do not consume fiction.
Yes.
Unless I go to the movies. That's the only place I get fiction.
I do too.
Because I feel like it's a waste of my time to read words. I feel almost a little bit guilty sometimes. I have the same guilt sometimes when I break away and play 4 hours of golf.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
You know,
yeah, yeah.
It's 4 hours away. Am I spending my time productively?
Yeah.
Even though I enjoy golf, but like, yeah, I feel like I want to read productive books.
Well, because there's information that you can apply. So I for me, I mean, you could tell me a story and there might be a parable in it that I could apply to my life, that would make it a little bit more interesting. But just some fiction for entertainment, first of all, my mind doesn't work that way, and I'm gonna forget everything I read. Where if I read things that are information driven, that are connected to my health, my wellness, my life, then that stuff's gonna go in. I'm gonna remember. I'm gonna pull that stuff out and use that information.
The picture of Laird Hamilton is now becoming more clear as this really competitive guy, but also very just self-driven.
Yeah.
Not like, you know, not a sum-zero game like I win, you lose, but more like I'm trying to be my very best day to day.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Because I've found that in the process, first of all, the more you can take control over your own destiny, the more you can take control over your own feeling of accomplishment, and the more you can own your personal fulfillment, the more fulfilled you'll be, the more accomplished you'll be. And then if you're not real, you can't let the behaviors of other dictate your success or failure. I think that's a mistake. I think we do that a lot. And so, I prefer taking control of it, and then I'm bound to be successful because I'm driving the bus of my happiness or my fulfillment.